Blessings, Lafayette family and Facebook friends. My daily message for Friday, September 30th. And I remind you, lots of great stuff is at fountainchurchtallahassee.org. And you can join us for worship every Sunday at 10:30, or you can worship with us virtually or by drive-up. My scripture today is Isaiah chapter 5, verse 11. Woe to those who rise early in the morning that they may run after strong drink, who tarry late into the evening as wine inflames them. This is the word of the Lord. Well, this is the closest scripture I could find to coffee. Coffee wasn't really a thing in New Testament times. It was usually wine. And there are many beverages today: tea, coffee, water, soda, and milk. But the morning coffee seems to have a particular blessing for many people in this modern, fast-paced world. And depending on which calendar you follow, today or tomorrow is International Coffee Day. So I had a few clever remarks, well, maybe not so clever, some funny, well, maybe not so funny, remarks about coffee. What's it called when you steal someone's coffee? A mugging. Divorce is like espresso, expensive and bitter. What do gossiping coffee pots do? Spill the beans. How did the hipster burn his tongue? He drank his coffee before it was cool. Well, there's no denying coffee has an important place in many of our lives. But let's remember the most important of all, which is the living water that Jesus Christ offers. Coffee may help us get through the day, but living water is what brings us life. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are nurtured and nourished. We have an abundance and an everlasting promise. So while you're enjoying your coffee on International Coffee Day, remember living water. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for living water in our lives. We thank you for faith, and many of us thank you for coffee. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.